This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is the first example of how to find the arc length of a circle. So we're going to do this problem here. Before doing it, what is the arc length? And is there a formula we can use? So if you remember, this is how we define the radian measure of an angle. We had this circle, and theta was the angle, and it's called a central angle because the center, you take the center of the circle for the vertex, and then we have the radius here of r, and this is the arc length. S right here is the length of the arc length. Okay, so we have theta equals S over r. So let's rewrite that as S over r equals theta. That's certainly the same thing. If instead of trying to find what theta is equal to, we want to know what the arc length is equal to, let's just multiply both sides by r, and then we'll have this formula. You could either write theta times r, or you can write S equals r theta. I've seen it both ways. And you could also use an alpha for your angle, any letter you want. But it's very important that this definition comes from the radian measure of theta. So theta must be in radians, which is a real number. Okay? So you have to have your angle in radians. It cannot be in degrees. So if in degrees, convert to radians. Before you put it in this formula. All right, so here's our formula. Doesn't really matter which one. Or you like to think about it. I always used to say r theta. I just said S equals r theta. That's what I remembered. But it comes again right from the definition of the radian measure of the angle. Theta is just simply S over r. All right, so now that we know that, let's go to our problem. So now, find the length of an arc intercepted by the central angle, pi over 3, in a circle of radius 10 feet. Well, let's get a picture of what's going on here first. Let's draw a picture. So I've got a circle, and this is 10 feet, right? That's 10 feet. And now, our angle is going to be pi over 3. Now, if you're not sure where that is, you can convert that to degrees. Some people think of it in terms of degrees. Another way of thinking about that is, well, you know, all the way over here is pi, so if you do it into thirds, that's where pi over 3 is. It ends up being 60 degrees. So in any case, you need to know how to draw that. So here my angle is pi over 3, right? So my angle here is pi over 3, and we are looking for S. All right, so we're trying to figure out how long this is right here, okay? So what do we know? We're given r and we're given theta, right? We're trying to find S. We know that r is the radius, that's the 10 feet. We know that theta is pi over 3. And we know the formula is S equals, well, I'm going to do it as r theta, okay? You could write it as theta times r. Really doesn't make any difference. Let's just plug it in. I need a little space here. So S equals, what am I going to plug in for r? 10 feet. Now, I'm going to leave the feet off for the moment, times pi over 3, and just put the feet over here, because it'll be, having the feet in the middle could confuse some people. And so that gives me 10 pi over 3 feet. Now, this is the exact answer. That's exactly how long it is. That's exact. But I did say to round your answer to the nearest tenth of a foot, so we can get a better picture. Right? There's the exact answer. So you do that in your calculator. Just put 10 pi over 3. So let's do that. So you have to put 10 times pi divided by 3 in your calculator, and then we're going to get the approximation, which is what we wanted. And you should get 10.5 if you round it. 10.5 feet, and that is the answer to this problem. Now look at the picture. Does it seem reasonable if the radius is 10, that this arc length, does that look like it's just over 10 feet? And, you know, it does look just about the same length. It's a little bit more. So that does seem like a reasonable answer. So we're going to do a lot more problems on the next videos on arc length. But in this one, notice that my angle was given in radians. If it's not in radians, you're going to have to convert it before you could plug it in the formula. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.